In this video lecture, we will learn how to design a digital low-pass filter from the given digital specifications. The given specifications are: passband ripple is less than or equal to 1.25 decibels at a passband edge frequency 200 Hz. Stopband attenuation is greater than or equal to 15 decibels at a stopband edge frequency of 300 Hz. The sampling frequency is 2 kHz. So, as a first step, we will compute the normalized edge frequencies with respect to the sampling frequency. Passband edge frequency in radians is equal to 2 pi times fp by sampling frequency. So the passband edge frequency is given to be 200 Hz and sampling frequency is given to be 2 kHz. Substituting these two values into this equation, the passband edge frequency in radians is equal to 2 pi into 200 by 2000, which gives us 0.2 pi radians. So the passband frequency is 0.2 pi radians. Next, the stopband edge frequency in radians is equal to 2 pi times fs, stopband edge frequency, by the sampling frequency. Substituting the values, we have 2 pi times 300 by 2000. This gives us the stopband edge frequency in radians is 0.35. The magnitude transfer function lies between 0 and minus 12.5 decibels for the radians frequency in from 0 to 0.25. That is, the passband ripple is about minus 1.25 decibels. And for the frequencies from 0.35 to pi, the magnitude is less than or equal to minus 15 decibels. So, the digital passband frequency is 0.25 radians and the digital stopband frequency is 0.35. So, we want to design a digital low-pass Butterworth filter using bilinear transformation. So, in order to use bilinear transformation, we need to find the analog frequencies. And the bilinear transformation says that we need to first pre-warp the digital frequencies to the corresponding analog frequencies. So the pre-warping is given by analog frequency is equal to 2 by t tan of digital frequency by 2. So we will substitute the values of the passband frequency, that is 0.2 pi. So assuming capital T value to be 1 second. So the analog passband frequency in radians per second is 0.649. Similarly, we compute the value of analog stopband frequency in radians per second to be 2 by t tan of stopband frequency is 0.3 pi radians, substituting that value, and we will compute it to be 1.01. So we are having the analog passband frequency, we are having the analog stopband frequency, and we are having the passband ripple as well as the stopband attenuation. So using these four, now next we will compute the order of the Butterworth filter required to meet the given specifications, as well as we will find the cutoff frequency of the filter also. The order of the filter n is greater than or equal to logarithm of under root of 10 to the power of 1.5 minus 1 by 10 to the power of 0.125 minus 1 divided by logarithm of stopband frequency to the passband frequency. Now the values are, the numerator is 0.984 and the denominator is 0.192 and the ratio value is 5.125. So we will round it off to the next higher integer. So it is 6. So for the given specifications, the order of the low pass filter required is 6. Now, we will use this order of the filter to compute the cutoff frequency of this filter. So, cutoff frequency is equal to pass band frequency by 10 to the power of 0.1 alpha p minus 1 to the power of 1 by 2 times capital N, where N is the order of the filter and we have computed it to be 6. And the passband attenuation is 1.25 decibels. So, substituting all the values, we will get the final computed value to be 0.7594. The cutoff frequency is 0.7594. So, we have the order of the filter to be 6 and the cutoff frequency to be 0.7594. Now, there are 6 poles which lie in the left half of the S-plane, which gives us the transfer function of this low pass filter. For n is equal to 6, the transfer function, that is the normalized transfer function of the Butterworth filter, that is for cutoff frequency is equal to 1, is 1 by s square plus 0.518s plus 1 times s square plus 1.414s plus 1 times s square plus 1.932s plus 1. So, this is the transfer function with respect to the cutoff frequency is equal to 1. Now, to get the desired transfer function at the obtained cutoff frequency, we need to substitute the variable s with s by cutoff frequency. Now, if we replace in this equation s with s by ohm c, then we are going to get cutoff frequency to the power of 6 by s square plus 0.518 ohm c s plus ohm c square times s square plus 1.414 ohm c s plus ohm c square times s square plus 1.932 ohm c s plus ohm c square. Now, substituting the value of the cutoff frequency into this one, we will get this equation. Now, this is the required transfer function at the desired cutoff frequency of the Butterworth filter. Now, this analog filter transfer function need to be transformed, mapped to the digital using bilinear transformation. So, thereby, if we replace S with 2 by T, 1 minus Z power minus 1 by 1 plus Z power minus 1, taking T is equal to 1 second into this equation, then we are going to get the H of Z. So, H of Z is equal to H of S with S replaced with 2 times 1 minus Z power minus 1 by 1 plus Z power minus 1. So, this is the design of the digital low pass Butterworth filter for the given specifications.